Shree Minerals is Chief Geologist Michael Busbridge. Michael, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. It's great to see you again.
Good to be catching up, Michael. You've been doing some RC drilling here at the Rock Lodge project in New South Wales, intersecting significant mineralisation. Tell us a bit more about the program.
Yeah, thanks very much, Andrew. Thanks for the opportunity. We've done 13 RC holes now into the project, which has only been granted for 7 months. So we're hitting the ground running, and we're getting some reasonable numbers. Like I said, it's not overly high grade, but they are occurring over a pretty good area, and determining a zone where we can follow up and chase along strike. And we're pretty hopeful that the surface sampling that we've done, as illustrated in figure two of the announcement, suggests that this zone may extend, well, at least another 200 metres to the north. And we don't know what's happening to the south because it dips undercover. So, look, we're hopeful that further drilling is going to identify some further mineralisation. You'll notice on figure three of the announcement that we have a diamond hole to plan that goes underneath our surface RC work. That's ultra critical for us. That will determine if our lenses that we're seeing in the RC work, if those lenses extend at depth. And if they do, wow, it's going to be exciting.
Well, how deep were you drilling here as part of the RC program?
Yeah, look, the RC work, our deepest hole was hole number five, which was 102 metres. And that was the hole that got some four or five zones of mineralisation mentioned in the announcement, just from about 70 through to 102 metres when too much water in the drillings ceased our activities there. We just couldn't go any further. So that's why we've got a diamond drill. But and all the other holes were quite shallow, 50, 60 metres. So that tells us one thing, that we didn't drill deep enough in a lot of holes.
And to the west, of hole five and hole two, you saw some good intersections.
And hole two also got some mineralisation right at the surface. So there's this 60 metre package of rock that is very certainly mineralized for us. And we hope to define that with more drilling to the north, to the south, and with diamond drilling at depth.
And when are you planning some of this follow-up work?
Yeah, Andrew, we hope to get back in there probably in July. There's quite a bit of rain over there. It's snowing, I think, in our particular area at Cooma there. But we hope to be in there maybe July, August, by the time we get approval sorted.
It's quite a large land package at Rock Lodge.
Yes, Andrew. We've only just drilled the actual Rock Lodge prospect itself. The exploration license covers about, 29 square kilometres. There are areas there where we're pretty keen to get on, to have a look at. There's old gold mines that haven't got a drill hole anywhere near them. But in New South Wales, it's all a private land, so there are statutory negotiations to do with landowners. And that's standard. You know, we know we have to do that. But at the moment, our focus is actually the Rock Lodge prospect, and we'll be in there as soon as possible.
But off to a good start.
Yeah, off to a wonderful start. I think the RC drilling answered a lot of questions for us. The diamond drilling will be even better for us when we'll be able to identify what the dips and strikes are of this mineralisation, and that'll help planning in future. It's ultra critical we get the diamond drilling done. We can then do stuff like downhole EM, which will identify massive sulphides at depth. There have been massive sulphides intersected in some of the old drilling that was done 5 to 6 years ago. Those particular companies didn't drill deep enough. We've learned our lesson, of course, but there has been massive sulphide intersected up near surface. We're hopeful that downhole EM will find something better, bigger and better.
Very interesting. Michael, good to speak. Thanks for your time.
Thanks very much, Andrew. Good on you.